Hello everyone, in this video we have one triangle. These two parts are given as equal. Here is given 6, this length is given 10, and ratio of these two angles is given 2. The question is, what is the length of the x? Okay. First step, if you notice that ratio of these two angles is given 2, that means we can create an isosceles triangle with base angles equal to alpha. So these are must be equal alpha. Okay. Let's call here point K. So triangle KAD is an isosceles triangle. Okay. Then, if you focus on triangle KDC, notice that this triangle has same base angles, right? That means triangle KDC is also an isosceles triangle. Therefore, this length must be equal to others. Next step, if you connect these two points, notice that these two parts are equal. That means angle BKC must be equal 90 degrees. Okay. Then, if you focus on this triangle, an isosceles triangle, so if you had a 6, this length must be equal 6 units, right? Okay. After that, if you focus on triangle KDC, triangle KDC is also an isosceles triangle, so if you draw a perpendicular line onto the base, like this, the base will be divided into two equal parts, right? So, if the base equals 16, that means these two parts must be equal 8 units, right? Okay. So, 2 units left here. Then, let's call here y. For this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get the value of y, right? Therefore, 2 squared plus y squared equals 6 squared. So y squared equals 36 minus 4. Y squared equals 32. That means y is going to be 4 root 2, right? Let's write here y equal 4 root 2. After that, if you focus on this triangle, this triangle and this triangle are similar, right? Why? Because notice that these two lengths are parallel. Right. After that, I want to represent this length with m. So, ratio of 4 root 2 over m must be equal 1/2, right? So, 1 over 2. That means m is going to be 8 root 2. That's right here, m equal 8 root 2. Finally, for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get value of x. So 6 squared plus 8 root 2 whole squared equal x squared. So 36 plus 128 equal x squared. That means x squared equal 164. So x is going to be 2 root 41. Right. This was the first method. Now we will calculate value of x. using second methods. First step, I want to create an angle bisector line here, like this. So these are must be equal alpha, right? And here must be equal to alpha. Next step, let's call here theta. If you focus on the triangle has theta, alpha, and 2 alpha. Now, if you focus on triangle ADC, this triangle has same angles, that means triangle DAT and triangle DCA are similar. Okay. Notice that there's an angle bisector line here, right? So according to angle bisector theorem, ratio of these two sides must be equal ratio of these two sides. So if here is 3k, that means here must be equal 5k. We know that these two parts are equal, so here is also 8k. Now we can apply similarity theorem. So 3k, which is opposite of the alpha, over 6, which is opposite of the alpha, must be equal 6, which is opposite of the 2 alpha, over 8k, right? Which is opposite of the 2 alpha. If you simplify the expression, so k squared equal 3 over 2, that means k is going to be root 3 over 2. Okay. Now, if you focus on triangle ABC, for this triangle, we can apply Stewart's theorem, right? So according to Stewart's theorem, square of this length, 6 squared, must be equal x squared times this part. So x squared times 8k plus square of this length times this part. So 10 squared times 8k over this length, 16k minus product of these two parts. So 64k squared. Okay. You know that k squared equal 3 over 2. That's right here. 3 over 2, if you simplify, so 96, right? Then, if you move this term left-hand side of the equation, so 36 plus 96 equal 132, right? Therefore, after the cross multiplication, 132 times 16k equal 8k times x squared plus 100 times 8k. Therefore, if you divide both sides of the equations by 8k, like this, these are again, right? So, 2 left here. Therefore, 264 minus 100 equal x squared. That means x squared equal 164. So x is going to be 2 root 41. Okay. Now we will calculate value of x using third methods. If we take here alpha degrees like this, and let's extend corner D, let's call here point M. If you focus on triangle AMC, notice that this triangle is an isosceles triangle, right? Okay. Notice that there is an angle bisector line here, right? So we know that ratio of these two sides must equal ratio of these two sides according to angle bisector theorem. So if there's a 3a here, this length must be equal 5a. Therefore, 6 plus 3a equal 5a. So 2a equals 6. That means a is going to be 3 units. Let's write here. Here is 9. Here is 15. Right? After that, I want to represent these two lengths with y. Let's clear here. So, for triangle ABC, if we apply cosine rule, according to cosine rule, x squared equal 10 squared plus 2y whole squared minus 2 times 10 times 2y times cosine alpha, right? Therefore, x squared equal 100 plus 4y squared minus 4y times cosine alpha. Okay. If we can calculate value of y and cosine alpha, we get the value of x, right? Therefore, for this triangle, I want to apply cosine rule to calculate value of y. So, y squared equal 6 squared plus 10 squared minus 2 times 6 times 10 times cosine 2 alpha, right? We know that triangle AMC is an isosceles triangle, so if we draw a perpendicular line onto the base will be divided into two equal parts. So now we can calculate value of cosine 2 alpha easily. Notice that cosine 2 alpha equal 5 over 15. So 1 over 3. If we plug in this value to the equation, so let's write here 1 over 3. If we simplify, that means y squared equal 36 plus 100 minus 40, right? So y squared equal 96, that means y is going to be 4 root 6. Then, to calculate cosine alpha, I want to use cosine 2 alpha. You know that the expansion of cosine 2 alpha equal 2 times cosine squared alpha minus 1. So, we know that cosine 2 alpha equal 1 over 3. And if we move minus 1 left-hand side of the equation, 1 plus 1 over 3 equal 4 over 3. If we simplify, that means cosine squared alpha equal 2 over 3. So cosine alpha is going to be root 2 over root 3. Right? Okay. Let's clear here. Therefore, x squared equal 100 plus 4 times y squared equal 96, right? Minus 40 times y equal 4 root 6 times cosine alpha equal root 2 over root 3. if we simplify root 2 left here, so x squared equal 100 plus 384 minus 320. That means x squared equal 164, so x is going to be 2 root 41. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye bye.